understand this demand lifespan of some of your in-home systems, your HVAC, or your roofing, your interior spaces. And that helps you in your long-term and short-term planning, thinking about where do I have to budget, how do I plan for the maintenance and operating costs. One of the pieces that the committee asked for in June was to help us think through what does really that look like, short-term, long-term reporting. The history did a numerous, they've been through head-to-toe everything on this side. They did a fabulous job getting out here quick so they can respond to this committee. And they rushed the presentation, so you're going to see a higher level review. One of the pieces they'll follow up with the district here in the next several weeks is that fine-grained spreadsheet on every single HVAC unit, every single piece of equipment we own, which gives us that fine-tooth data about what those costs are and the needs of the system. So Mark is going to here to take it away and tell us a little bit about their findings from their review on, again, the high school, primary school, district office, and the maintenance grounds transportation.
Yeah, thanks for having me, folks. Yes, I'm Mark from McKinstry. I've been working with them for 20 years, 13 years before that, doing facility work with some major projects. We're out here a couple weeks ago, and then I'm with them for that. I've been out here for 3 days, and I use local facilities. So, this is very preliminary. We don't have everything baked. HVAC system or electrical system. We also did some kitchen 3.28. So on our scoring, kind of think of it as a golf score. You want to have a low score of 1 is good, and 5 is bad. Makes it a little bit unsatisfactory, approximately less than 10% of its life remaining or the component has failed. So at a 3.28, you're fair to staring at poor. Average estimated remaining life is just under 8 years. It took all the components. Again, this is just 572, which is getting there. And a 30-year capital ease for all the components, if you change them out over 30 years, we're about $11 million. So, still got a ways to go, but kind of how things are looking right now. So, Orting High School, 2.99. What really helps that is the newer portion that was built. The equipment's in really good condition, and maintained very well. The facilities team is doing a great job. And I must say, with all the equipment that's out there and some of the age, they're doing a remarkable job of keeping some of the stuff going. So, yeah, that's a great job you're doing. So 2.99, that old gym, I think that's where by the time, I don't think I have the roof yet on there. It's in rough shape, the old gym, mid-50s. The primary school, 3.42, so it's getting into the core. We still have some more to add into that. The district office, transportation, pretty high on the scoring as well. Old buildings. It's not one on there. So we take a 30-year capital as it stands now. First, second years, there's a lot of needs. Somebody working with Curtis, we're trying to spread that out a little bit, kind of make it more realistic for you guys. But that's all part of the process. It's a consulting process. I don't know if you have $1.5 million at your disposal right now, but in the next couple of years, there's a few million dollars here that we need to prioritize and figure out what's important. So 30 years, that's nice to know, but what's like in front of you? Usually 5 years is kind of reasonable to try and figure out what kind of expenditures you should be looking at. So Orting High School, $2.8 million, the old gym, and this is not done yet, $178,000. The primary school, $1.3 million. District office transportation, $400,000 each. And then we break out by the type of system. So for all those schools for the district, about $2.2 million in mechanical, $400,000, and $400,000 for life safety, etc. We did include in the specialty systems the replacement of, or to go on top of the field down here, so that's $500,000. So just trying to hit just a couple of high points. There are many, many other high points. But probably one of the most remarkable is on the old gym on the corner south side by the portables. We've got some chunks, and that's fallen. So you're not in danger when I came back out and it fallen. But there's some pretty good cracks going on. We recommended a seismic. Probably should be done at some point if you're going to be staying in that building long term. Here's some pretty good cracks in the concrete columns. Roof, AC, pretty poor condition. I'm not sure if it works. Yeah, it wasn't at the time there. The high school, older section, a lot of those components have probably met their expected useful life if they were putting the plan together. We saw the water heater in the newer section. Once you start seeing moisture in the base of the water heater, things are probably going to start to let loose. And
been misspent or exceeded. There's a lot better mechanical components out there, indoor quality can improve, reliability can improve.
Equipment seems to be working pretty good, but the
$11 billion over 30 years. So there's a hole, there's things 10, 15 years out, like the roofs that you don't need to worry about for a while. But we just, with the 30 years, there are components that may need to be replaced twice. So we do 30 years. So you might have some small exhaust fans or some pumps that have 12 to 15 years estimated life. You just put that in so you can understand that some components will need multiple replacements. And some components like, you know, foundations, part of the FCA, exterior walls. You're not going to replace those walls in 15, 20, 30 years, but you're going to maintain them. So we'll put $10,000 to repoint around, so you know,
just transportation and admin.
3.7, 3.68, 3.7, so they're in the poor. And on transportation, there's an old boiler in there that's been decommissioned, but if we scored that,
all
three, four, and 5 years, that's 15, 18, 20%. You're going to be paying more. So it's another reason we're kind of loading it up here in front and trying to tell the story. You're going to get more of your money now as opposed to 5 or 10 years down the road.
Make a solid recommendation to the board of directors.
So we have three more meetings. That will take us from where we're at today to a final recommendation. Next time we're together, on the 28th of September, we'll be at Orting High School. We're going to spend a little bit longer in a tour. Probably take about a full hour of that. And then we're going to hear through our assess valuation, our bond agent, Trevor Carlson from Piper Sandler. We'll share information about a 10-year projection for our assess valuation, which will help you as a committee to see what would be affordable. If I wanted to run a bond package now in the near term or midterm, how much money could we borrow? Keeping a consistent tax rate for our voters. That's an interest that the board of directors has. They don't want local taxes to spike one year and drop another, that kind of thing. So we'll share that date on the 28th. On the 12th of October, we'll be together also at the Orting High School PAC, and we will summarize this information. So our architects are going to work in a way in a process for us to consider all these different pieces and make sure that we have all that in our forefront thinking as we make a draft recommendation. We're going to break apart the small areas to process that. Also on the 12th, you'll hear a little bit about our current land inventory. So we talked a little bit about what we had today. We'll look at that through the big picture, and they're going to try to help us unpack what's buildable, where can we grow, that kind of thing. We're going to make that recommendation, draft recommendation on the 12th, and then the team is going to take that information and bring that back in one more meeting on the 26th of October, which is where we're going to summarize and present back to the committee. This is what we heard. How did we do? And that will turn into a final recommendation at that point to the board of directors. So if we are doing it well, we've considered all of those pieces, the facility condition, the land availability, the cost, the affordability, our enrollment growth, and we just want to know if we're missing anything. On your way out, if you have a committee thought, I really wish I could see this or know this, our committee, architects, attorneys, myself will be up in this, just pause and stop and say, hey, I'd like to know more about this, or I'm wondering about this, and we'll do our best to incorporate that in our next 3 meetings. We want to make sure that you have everything that you feel like you need to make a recommendation to the board. We'll also come back to this survey information. You've seen the inside of our facilities, what our folks wrestle with every day, and the board really values your input. We're going to bring this back. So either today before you go or electronically, please fill out that survey and let us know what you see as strengths or challenges of our facilities. We'll use that data to come back and help us process and make a recommendation on the floor. So I think that's about it for today. Thank you for taking time away from your busy lives, your loved ones, your families, your work. We know it was an extra ask, but literally we are charting the way for our school district for the next 10 years. And we need things now, and we need to come back to the table in the next 3 or 4 years. It used to be Orting. You do a thing, and then 20 years later, we come back and do another, and 20, we can't wait 20 years. This is too critical, too urgent. So your time is very much appreciated. Board, did I miss anything? Any final comments? All right, thank you so much for coming. And again, if there's something we haven't shared in our plan, please come, stop by, let us know what you'd like to see. We'll make sure we can try to get that.